Exclusive brand new polling on the first in the nation Iowa caucuses. And sitting at the top, a man who isn't even in the race yet. Here are the results from our CNN Des Moines Register MediaCom poll. Former Vice President Joe Biden edging out Senator Bernie Sanders 27-25% as the top choice for likely Democratic caucusgoers in Iowa. CNN's Ryan Nobles is in Washington breaking down all the numbers for us. Ryan, we know the Des Moines Register poll has been touted as the gold standard of polling for decades because of its accuracy. But while the news is good for Biden and Sanders, some other top-tier candidates are kind of struggling to get out of the single digits.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that, Anna. And I can tell you that the campaigns have been burning up our phones today trying to learn what these numbers were, but we wouldn't tell them until we revealed them with you tonight at 8 o'clock. And the last time we took the temperature of these Iowa voters, there were very few candidates in the race. But I can tell you, I was in Iowa this morning, having just returned there from a campaign swing with Bernie Sanders. And there's no doubt that this race is definitely on in the Hawkeye State. We now have 14 candidates who are officially announced or have at least formed exploratory committees. And despite having so many of these candidates in the field, the results have really not changed all that much from our survey back in December. So let's take a look again at where these numbers stand right now. Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders top the field, and they do so by a pretty wide margin. Sanders trailing behind Biden by only 2 points, and there's not even another candidate who can even crack 10%. Elizabeth Warren at 9%, Kamala Harris at 7%, Beto O'Rourke has 5%, Cory Booker and Amy Klobuchar both register 3%. Not one other candidate of the 20 that we put in this poll registered above the 1% mark. That's important because a candidate must earn at least 1% in three different polls to gain access to the upcoming DNC debates. Now, there is some movement from what we saw back in December, and that movement really is to the benefit of Bernie Sanders. Take a look at the comparison to where things stood in December. Sanders at that point only at 19%. Biden was at 32%. Well, Sanders has grown quite a bit now. He's up to 25%. Biden has lost some ground down to 27%. The other candidates in the race really haven't changed all that much, although the one number I will point out for you here, Anna, is Beto O'Rourke. Not in the race yet. A lot of anticipation he's going to get in. He was at 11% in December. He's now fallen to only 5%. Anna?
That is interesting, although it's particularly noteworthy, I think, that the two candidates that are on that slate there who have lost support are the two that have not yet declared their candidacy.
That's right. That's right.
I'm curious if the age of Iowa caucus goers influences their vote.
It really does, Anna. And let's take a look at the influence in particular of young people. You know, as I mentioned, I was in Iowa this week at an Iowa caucus event with Bernie Sanders on a college campus in Iowa City. There were so many young people there that are so passionately behind his campaign. And that's really reflected in the poll numbers that we see among young voters. Take a look at this. Voters under the age of 45 support Sanders the most at 32%. Conversely, when you flip that number to the group over 45, that's to Joe Biden's benefit, where he takes 32% of the vote. And there's no doubt, certainly a lot of energy with young voters. Generally, the older voters, especially in a caucus state like Iowa, where it does require some work to go out and cast your ballot, that vote tends to be a lot more reliable. But of course, Anna, the big caveat we have to add anytime we talk about polls, especially this far out, is that there is a long, long way to go before any votes are cast. You know, it's very unlikely that what we see from this snapshot today in time turns out to be how it is a year from now. But it does give us some idea of how Iowa voters are thinking.
Well, look at how things have changed in just the last couple of months there. Ryan Nobles, thank you for breaking it down for us. Joining us now is CNN senior political analyst Mark Preston, Neera Tanden, former policy director for Hillary Clinton and president of the Center for America Progress, and former Republican congressman from Pennsylvania and CNN political commentator Charlie Dent. Mark, let's dig into the numbers a little bit deeper, because while Biden is at the top of that poll, he has dropped 5 points from December, while Bernie Sanders, we see, is up 6 points. Do you think this means Biden needs to hurry up and make a decision about running, or is it still too early to matter?
You know, I think we're going to hear the former vice president give us his decision fairly soon. I think we'll probably hear within the next few weeks. There's been a lot of pressure for him to finally make a decision. But we've seen a couple of signs that we think that he is going to be running for president. We saw that Michael Bloomberg has decided that he is not going to seek the presidency. And there's always been the thought that if Michael Bloomberg and Joe Biden were to run at the same time, they would basically cancel themselves out. So if you see Michael Bloomberg stepping away, and we know that the vice president is very much interested in running, then perhaps that's what we're seeing right now. You know, I do think that we shouldn't be too surprised by these numbers. Right now, Joe Biden, of course, he's going to lose a few points because people are waiting for him to get in. They're also talking more about him. And whenever you start talking about somebody more in the news, their negatives are going to climb. Bernie Sanders just announced that he was running for president, did a CNN town hall about a week ago. I think that's why we're seeing his numbers jump as well. His supporters are now seeing that he's no longer on the sidelines, but he's in the game. That's why we see those two so far at the top. But as we heard earlier, as Ryan said, we are still very early right now. And even those 1%ers right now, Anna, I'll just tell you, I was just texting with somebody who received 1% in our poll, and they are very happy about that. So let us not devalue that too much, because it's very important. You need to get that 1% to get into the debates. And if you get a 1% in our poll, that's pretty good news right now for you.
They could get on to the bigger stage. Neera, I want to look at the battle for third, and the fact that really no one else is above 10%. No one else has cracked into the double digits besides Sanders and Biden. If you're Elizabeth Warren or Kamala Harris or one of these other candidates, how concerned should you be?
Well, this is what I think a really important point in this poll. Basically, Vice President Biden and Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders ran before. He has 100% name ID. Even in this poll, you see that the, like, Senator Warren, Senator Harris, Beto O'Rourke, Cory Booker, they have strong approvals, but, you know, there's still a large number of Iowans who don't know them or don't know them well. So I actually think they have a lot of room to grow in this poll. And particularly, it is interesting to me that Vice President Biden is so far ahead, not having declared. And I think Beto O'Rourke is obviously another person who hasn't declared so far. So I think it's interesting that we have the two front runners that we had before, when we have one of them that hasn't declared so far.
Congressman, Democrats obviously want to pick the candidate that can ultimately win back the White House. And in this poll, age and ideology were big dividers. Among those under age 45, Sanders has a 9-point edge over Biden. But among the older, likely caucus goers, Biden is 15 points ahead there. And then when you look at the ideology, Sanders leads Biden by 9 points among those who consider themselves liberals, but among moderate or conservative caucus goers, Biden has a wide edge, 36% to Sanders, 18%. Is there anything in that data that tells you who has the kind of support that should worry President Trump the most?
Well, I'll tell you what, I think there are two things in this poll that really jumped out at me, that Senator Sanders and Vice President Biden, their leads at the moment, I think, are largely driven by high name ID. That's the first thing. But I do think that Democrats generally are going to be driven by their more progressive wing, which seems to me wants a next generation of leadership, something new, something fresh. I would not be very comfortable if I were Joe Biden looking at those numbers. You have to think that Kamala Harris or Cory Booker or Beto O'Rourke or maybe even Elizabeth Warren, although I doubt it, but one of them is going to emerge and break through, because I really think this is about the next generation of leadership. Now, if you're President Trump, I'd probably not like to run against Joe Biden. But no matter what, the Democrats are energized and enthused, and that's going to be the biggest challenge for the president.
Let's talk more about the Democrats on the campaign trail today, because, Mark, you're there at South by Southwest, where a lot of people were watching to see whether Beto O'Rourke would use the screening of a documentary about him to announce a presidential run. Now, that didn't happen, but here's what did happen when he was asked about the decision to do the documentary. Watch.
David asked me if he could do this at breakfast one day in Austin, and I was like, yeah, what the f-? I mean, we're running for Senate, and we've got, you know, if you want to bring a camera along sometimes. I just didn't think it would be this.
We had to bleep it out there, Mark. Is he ready for prime time?
Yeah, no doubt. Look, we're in a different paradigm right now than we were just, say, 2 years ago. You have the likes of Beto O'Rourke, who seems to connect with the younger generation and speaks his mind. All we do is take two steps back on. If we remember Beto O'Rourke, he wasn't even a choice of the Democratic establishment to run for the Senate here in Texas. They didn't want him to run against Ted Cruz this last time, and he came out of nowhere, and he did so well. Now they wanted him to run for the Senate. He decided not to. You know, it's interesting, when he was on stage at that exact time, when he was on stage talking about that documentary, his Senate campaign sent out an email. They weren't asking for money, but what they were asking is to build their list, because what they were saying is, you should be the first to know
you should be the first to know whether Beto O'Rourke decides to run for president. Come join us now and be the first to know. So basically, again, another sign that Beto O'Rourke is inching towards running for president right now. This is a sign of building up a campaign, building up supporters, and really letting them know that you are about to pull the trigger and jump into the race.
Yeah, because he's building up a lot of suspense. If he doesn't join the race, can you imagine how upset some of these people, his supporters, his biggest fans, are going to be?